has to do with what you need. And it depends a little bit on the future you're preparing for. So say I'm trying to prepare somebody for a known future. Say I've got a kid, 100 years ago, his dad was a farmer, he's going to be a farmer too. So it's a known future. We know exactly what his life is going to look like. If you know exactly what your life is going to look like, you need knowledge. You need the right answer. We need to spend time teaching you the right answer, and if you apply the right answer, we'll all be fine. But probably about 50 years ago, we found out there's a lot of occupations where the future is unknown. Because if you're going to be a doctor or you're going to be a lawyer, I can't give you the right answer. So you're going to be a doctor. This is the answer you give every time. Like, no, it doesn't work that way. You know, you're going to be a lawyer. This is what you say in court and then you win. No, it doesn't work that way. What you need are skills. If you apply this analysis, if you apply this presentation, if you apply these argumentation techniques, if you do these things and learn these skills, no matter what future you will get into, you will be able to work your way out of it. But this requires that the future is kind of knowable, because I need to know the types of situations you're going to be in, because then I can tweak the skills to those situations. But we're slowly moving into a place where the future is unknowable. You've got somebody like Elon Musk saying we're going to have 1 million people on Mars in 50 years. I challenge you to create the curriculum, 8 easy steps of living on Mars. You know, what knowledge are we going to teach them? You know, what skills are we going to teach them? I don't know. No way of knowing that. But some things are timeless. Your life attitude is timeless and your self-awareness is timeless. I call it the Rome Mars test. If we're going to teach our kids something, we want it to be timeless. So how do we know something's timeless? Well, if something would be useful in ancient Rome, and if it's going to be useful if you're living on Mars, then probably it's reasonably universal, as much as we can kind of figure out, right? So knowing the capitals of the state of the US is going to be useful in Rome, not so much. Is it going to be useful on Mars? Not so much. But being able to set goals and persevering. Ancient Rome, probably be pretty popular if you're good at setting goals and persevering to reach them, and probably on Mars you will still be. If you are sociable, if you are perseverant, if you're optimistic, if you like learning, those are all traits that whether we live 2,000 years ago or if you're going to live on Mars, probably that's going to help you. And actually the right life attitudes and self-awareness will make that you will learn the skills, and those will make sure that you get the knowledge that is necessary. So this is one of the things that I truly believe that the education system needs to broaden to cover all these areas. And this actually is what I see in most gifted programs as well. That education as a whole starts out usually with a lot of focus on knowledge and a little bit of skill. And most gifted programs start including more skills as they go along, like executive functions and cooperation and stuff like that. And recently there's been a lot of focus on stuff like learning a growth mindset. As a skill to or a life attitude to add, and adding, you know, what are your talents? Knowing what my talents and traits are, that's actually pretty useful to know. So it's broadening the perspective. And I like what Eric Hoffer actually quite a while already said. It's in times of change, the learners will inherit the earth, while the learned will find themselves prepared for an earth that no longer exists. And that's really something we're moving into right now. The world is changing faster and faster. Concrete example is self-driving cars.